presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to John in Orlando. Hey, John, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, good afternoon to you. How are you?
I'm doing great, man.
I want to thank you, first of all, before I ask you about the thaw, you and DeMord and all the gang at TFNN. I had a really, really good year after the October call you guys made. My 401k is up 72%.
Congratulations, man.
A couple of things I made with Coinbase and other stocks that I made, and I've had a good year.
And we appreciate you growling and prowling with us, man. That's a beautiful thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Always do your best. Express your own divinity. You don't need to accept. You don't need the acceptance of others. You don't need knowledge or great philosophical concepts. You have the right to be you and to express yourself and to express your divinity by being alive, loving yourself and loving others. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 180, NASDAQ up 213, S&P's up 50. It is a melt-up in a monster way. Gold contract down $16, trading at $2,333 an ounce. You get silver flat, $29.49 an ounce. Light sweet crude, up $2, $80.42 a barrel. Notes and bonds, 10-year note, down 14 ticks, trading 110.12. The 30-year off 28 at 119.18 in King Dollar. King Dollar trading down 210, 105.333, Euro 107, Yen trading 157, British Pound 127 to 1 U.S. Dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. Well, we're going to the futures first. Let's take a look at the futures. ESA. 1 second. There we go. Okay. So intraday here, you're going to see just a total parabolic melt-up. And what you have here is that you do have volume at the highs. So there's no sells. There hasn't been a sell all day, folks. Well, yeah, the last 50 minutes you will have gone sideways. But see this high? That high has volume, man. The last two bars of the high have volume, so that's an hour ago. Was it, 2 o'clock and 2:10. That's on your ES. On your NQs, I suspect it's going to be the same thing. Whoops. Okay, we take a look at the NQs. Exact same setup. Look at that. Isn't that wild? So, yeah, same thing, 2 o'clock and 2:10, you get volume there. You can see all day, just trending all day. Each time you actually did take a swing point out, we had volume. The first swing point was taken out at 12:20. Next swing point was taken out at 13:10. And that just kept, well, and then the next swing point was taken out at 13:30. And then you made a high, and the high has volume, man. So there's nothing down here saying that you're going to go back down out here today. Gold. We take a look at the gold market out here. Gold's down $15. Now, this is good. See that 114,000 contracts? That's what you're looking for. We didn't get to the low. You didn't reject the price, but you can see this contraction. The contraction's good. We take a look at the silver market. Silver, same type of setup. 49,000 contracts. Now, this is also, it's a good scene. So, we had come down last Thursday on 117,000. You rejected lower price today at $29.09. You're at $29.43 and you did $49,000. So that's a good setup. What's not a good setup still is the dollar. So we take a look at this. Now, the market's certainly not paying attention to it today. There's no doubt about that. But bottom line, this dollar, it's down 204 ticks. You're still in the larger range. And you're way in the larger. You're way in the larger range. The higher range, rather, at 104.976. Well, it's not that much. It's 400 ticks, I guess. But bottom line, my take is that we're going up here. And we'll see whether the market's going to pay attention to it or not. We go in the note and bond market. We take a look at the note and bond market. This is oscillating around its swing point. You know, we took the swing out. Had pretty good volume on the way up. You're pulling back with light volume. And you're right at the cusp of going in. So the 10-year is at 110.12 and 110.09 gets you back in the lower range. So we're not in the lower range just yet. We're still in the higher range, which no doubt is a big deal. Some of the higher volume equities out here, we take a look at. You got NVIDIA's flat. You get Tesla up $9. You get GameStop down $3. Now, what is going to happen, I brought this up on Friday when I was doing the show, and what has happened is that this is going to be more than likely the rebalancing at the end of this month is going to be one monster, because what's going to happen here is that the XLK, as of today, it looks like this rebalancing is going to take place. Now, when you see this rebalancing, this is about as intense as you get. Now, I've seen these before when they disrupt the market, and I've seen them when they don't. So it really depends. You know, you just don't know. That's the real bottom line. But the amount of stock that's going to get sold is huge. And what it is this. So when we look at the XLK, watch what's going to happen here. Now, this is, I believe this is happening on the 21st. So what's going to happen is that this gets really wild when you look at this. Okay. Oh, no, I do it this way. 1 second. I got to go. The holdings. Okay. So watch what's going to happen here. What's going to happen right now, the way it works, is that Microsoft is 22%. Apple's 21%. And NVIDIA is 6%. Well, NVIDIA, because of the regulations inside the XLK, Apple and NVIDIA are going to swap places. So NVIDIA is going to go up to 21, 22, and Apple's going to come down to 6. Now, the amount of shares that have to be sold in order to do that is going to really screw with people's heads, man. So if you're in Apple or NVIDIA, you really want to, like, take a look at it. And my understanding right now is I believe it's going to be the 21st. Now, every day they're going to update this because it can change up until that deal. Here it is, yeah. So NVIDIA will take number 2 spot in technology select following a close race. The major shakeup is coming to the popular XLK following Friday's race to the finish close. Okay, so here it is. Microsoft's going to be number 1. NVIDIA's going to be number 2, man, so it's happening. So that deal's going to take place. So they're going to sell $10 billion worth of... Holy cow. They're going to buy $10 billion worth of NVIDIA. Stay right there. Come back when I'm here, Mr. Steve Rhodes.
If you spend any time online researching trading techniques on how to begin your trading journey, you've no doubt come across many folks who push Forex trading as a way to make big money quickly. Unfortunately, there are equally as many stories of these so-called Forex professionals just looking to make a quick buck off aspiring traders without actually teaching the ins and outs of the Forex market. This is what sets Teddy Keckstack's The Tiger Forex Report off the riffraff. Every Monday, former Chicago Mercantile Exchange member and author Teddy Keckstack releases his Tiger Forex Report newsletter, where he dives into the complex world of Forex and takes time to actually teach you his methods that have made him so successful in the fast-paced and rewarding world of Forex trading. Furthermore, all subscribers receive access to archived live streams of Teddy's, where he provides university-level education to help you in Forex trading. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Forex awaits.
The stock market is a delicate interconnecting web of commodities, equities, and trader psychology. When one string of the web is pulled, it has a ripple effect across the broader market. This is where opportunity lies. But how are you to gather all of this information into one cohesive model when you're already spending your energy looking for any possible trade opportunities? Luckily, you don't have to worry about that, as Tom O'Brien has brought all important market news to you in one single newsletter, Market Insights. Market Insights provides a daily overview of what's happening in the indexes, bonds, gold, and more. Follow along with Tom daily as he analyzes the components that affect the overall movement of the stock market, giving insight into how each one plays either a bullish or bearish role. Tom also analyzes specific equities that he believes has the potential to make huge returns, and his track record proves his analysis right. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Don't let the market leave you in the dust.
Are you ready to take charge of your financial future? TFNN is your gateway to the world of trading and investing. Whether you're starting out or scaling up, TFNN empowers traders and investors of all skill levels with top-notch investing systems, strategies, and techniques. It's time to protect and grow your money with insight you can trust. Join us live Monday through Friday during market hours for exclusive content that moves with the markets. At TFNN, we bring the trading floor to you. Our seasoned hosts are here to answer your calls and questions live on the air. Check out the Tiger's Den for just $1 and follow us on YouTube and become part of our vibrant community. And remember, at TFNN, we're so confident in the value we provide that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all new premium newsletter subscriptions and services. You have absolutely nothing to risk, so why wait? Tune in live to Tiger TV and transform your trading journey, because when you know better, you invest better. Join us and experience the difference today. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks, to Dow. Dow Industrials right now trading up 217. You get the NASDAQ up 237. S&Ps are up 57. Let's get over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show here every trading day. Also has a great newsletter, Mastering Probability. Now, it's very easy to get Mastering Probability, folks. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under Featured Content. You're going to see it on the right-hand side, Mastering Probability. You can get Mastering Probability for 1 month for $149. You get it 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 at 22%. You get it for one full year for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 or 33%. Now, they all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Steve has a huge amount of tools on the newsletter page with directions of how to use them so you understand how Steve looks at the market each and every day. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, good to be back with you. It's been a kind of a respite the past couple of weeks. I guess one was holiday, and then last week was just so sick. There was just no way I was going to come out
of
here.
That's a beautiful thing that you're back. That's right.
Yeah, I like it. I would not say 100%, but okay. I am back. You know, and that it is good to be back with you. We could talk sports for this entire segment. We won't.
I know.
But whether it's golf or hockey, certainly we got, you know, the hockey game. I assume you saw the game four.
I did, yeah. And it's like, oh boy, it's gonna all basketball, right? It's like, oh my god, and yeah. I got to go to Rory though first, because if you saw that, folks, it was a 2.5-foot putt, and it's like, oh my God, he just couldn't do it. And it's that course is hard.
It had break in it, though. It definitely had break. You could see on his foot to the upside. You could see that break, so it's kind of like, how's he going to deal with that? But unfortunately, he had missed a similar putt two holes before, so he had some, you know, bad webs. He needed to believe that. You know, that you got to be a pioneer of your future, not a prisoner of your past.
I'm telling you, and that's how DeChambeau hit that chip shot. There's no doubt. He hit that. If you saw this, folks, he hit that with confidence, man. It was a crazy one coming out of the sand, and he stopped that ball, man. That was pretty intense, man.
And he had a putt that was not necessarily the easiest
either, right? I know. Yeah, no doubt. I know.
But actually, the coolest thing about yesterday's tournament was really afterwards. And I happened to just – I was kind of flipping between some swimming Olympic stuff that was going on and the golf channel. And I happened to catch the golf channel just as Bryson DeChambeau was coming out and being interviewed. And it was really a wonderful, good, feel-good interview. Yep. So after the interview, you kind of figured that was over. And this over the past month or so, they've had an ex-player from the PGA Tour be more on the course, maybe try, attempt some shots, things of that sort. And so this was after the Bryson DeChambeau interview, maybe about 5 minutes later. And this gentleman was back in that bunker with a club, and he was going to try to make that shot. And he actually did the very first time. But after that first shot, DeChambeau pulled up in a golf cart. And it was the greatest exchange. And he said to this player, I apologize, I forget his name off the top of my head right now. But he said, you can make the shot. He looked at the club. It was basically said, yeah, this is the right club to use. And he hits this guy, this gentleman hits the shot and puts it inside of where DeChambeau got it. Now, the first shot that the guy took flew over the green or somewhere.
Okay.
And it is a very difficult shot to make. But then, you know, it's like DeChambeau gave him the confidence. Just passed over the confidence. DeChambeau had the, you know, that was for winning the U.S. Open. DeChambeau had the trophy with him.
Yep.
He gives him the trophy.
Raises his hand.
You know, it was just, it was an even better feel good.
No, so, I know. And, you know, it's a shame, man, because Liv seems to get all the good players, man. I mean, it was nice watching them. Do you know what I mean? It was like, okay, man, it's a different game, you know.
Yeah.
And I know there's animosity all over the place, but the bottom line is that they seem like they get the best players, man. I mean,
they do. So that was great. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow night to see if Florida can actually go ahead and wrap it up. So glad I believe everything in life has happened for us. And I think for Florida residents, get that game back here. You want to win the cup on your home ice.
Oh, right? Man, that'd be a trip. No doubt.
Yeah.
Especially for you guys over there. You go out of your mind. That's awesome, man. Yeah. A Florida team win the Stanley Cup. I mean, I know. I mean, we've done it, but that's right. That's amazing when you think about it. I know.
No, for sure. Yeah. For sure. Well, we're the lower peninsula for all the states in the north, right? So all the hockey players come to. Hey, the hockey players love it.
Folks, I'm not kidding. You should see the fan base in Florida for hockey. I mean, you'd never know that it's 100 degrees out.
However, there is no fan base like Edmonton, though.
Yeah.
And when they do their national anthem, that's another great feel good moment.
That is.
I mean, even though it's not ours, it's just such a cool process that they use out there. So we'll talk a little bit about the markets here. Actually, don't have the normal setup, but what I've got on our screen right now, Tom, are five really important charts out here. And the reason why they're really important is because each of them have topping signals. So the first one is going to be the semiconductor index. And so the pattern that I'm referring to here is called the TD9 count pattern.
Okay.
And in a TD9 count top, the high of that pattern must occur on either bars 8, bar 9, or the bar following bar number 9. Today for the semis, it's going to be bar number 9. That's going to confirm the pattern. So we're going to have confirmed tops today in the semiconductors, the SMH, which has a different holding structure than the semiconductor index.
Yes.
The NASDAQ 100, the XLK, and you were talking about the XLK just a little while ago, and the S&P. Now, the S&P 500 actually is going to complete its pattern today. And this is really important because the way that this pattern would get negated, folks, is not testing today's high, but closing above today's high. So come tomorrow, we'll know pretty good whether or not there is likely at least some type of short-term top in place. So I don't know what the actual close of the S&P 500 is going to be right now, but what folks should do is watch that high. The other instruments out here, the XLK, the NASDAQ, the SMH, the semis, their high could come tomorrow. So this is just setting us up for the potential of at least some type of retracement. I'm not talking about a major retracement, but you have to take things one step at a time.
Right.
Right now, the first step is there any kind of topping pattern that is out there? And here I'm sharing with you that there is. Now, one of the other cool things that I like to do is take a look at the equal-weighted ETFs. And this chart here, now for this, we take a look at the ETF. So you've got the Qs at the bottom, the SPYs, and you got the Dow Diamonds out there. So the SPYs, you can see they're going to complete their TD9 count top today. So a close above that tomorrow negates the signal. It says we continue to move on higher, complete the A to B equals CD pattern. That would be the next one that could come into play. And then if we got a bearish reversal candle, that would confirm a top. But if you take a look at the top row, Tom, even the Q, the equated ETF is still not taking out its high. And I'm referring to the high from back on May 23rd.
Yes.
There was volume on that trading day of 116 million shares. So far today, we've done 85, so we're coming to that swing point light. Hasn't taken it out. If you look at the S&P 500 equal weight, the RSP, we're nowhere even close to the highs. In fact, price is trading into resistance, which would be the oscillator and change line, and that has remained to be resistance since May 22nd.
Wow.
May 20, right? So equal. So it tells us that certainly here, we take a look at equal weighted versus weighted. All the work is being done by the heavily weighted instruments inside the NASDAQ and inside the SPYs. And the equal weighted usually point us in the right direction. So what I'd like people to do, even if we take a quick peek here at the equity future contracts, you're going to get a TD9 count top that's going to complete tonight, going to complete in just a little bit of time out there. So everybody should be watching those highs out there inside the ES Mini. Just simply to give us a feel for whether or not we've really got a short-term top or not.
Yeah, and I can tell you, this is really unusual in the summer that you have a melt-up on a Monday, man. This is pretty intense.
Big melt-up.
Yeah, big time. Listen, folks, real easy to get Steve's newsletter, TFNN. Feature content, mastering probability. Steve, have a great one, a safe one. Thank you.
Thanks, Tom. Take care.
Many trading newsletters attempt to focus on a narrow set of equities or commodities. While this works for some, it oftentimes misses many opportunities that possess huge gain potential. But how is an independent trader supposed to scan the entire market looking for these hidden opportunities? One simple answer, the Opening Call newsletter. Basil Chapman, developer of the Chapman Wave trading methodology, has been trading the markets for longer than most trading influencers have been alive. And over that time, he has honed his methodology in order to accurately call movements in a wide range of equities, from semiconductors to uranium to key indices and so much more. Basil is old school, taking the time to educate the trader while also giving his insights into key indices, selective stocks, and more. Opening Call subscribers also receive access to dozens of educational live streams that can be accessed at any time for your edification. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So, ignore the pop trading influencers and start learning time-tested technical analysis.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year Award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019, finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn. And he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
The consistency you're looking for is closer than you think. One or two adjustments are usually all you need to change your equity curve from red to green and keep it there. Come join Larry Pesavento live to learn what separates the winners from the losers. Join Larry Pesavento on the second and fourth Friday of every month for 3 hours of live trading from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Time, where Larry will show you the market setting up and, most important of all, the state of mind of a winning trader. By watching Larry trade, you'll learn the Fibonacci levels, you'll learn how to apply A to B to C to D trading patterns, you'll learn trade management, pattern recognition, and much more. Join Larry Pesavento on Friday, June 14th and Friday, June 28th this month for his live trading sessions, where you'll sit right beside him as he trades the market live. For this month only, enter code LARRYJUNE24 and save $50 off your first month. For all the information and to reserve your spot today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This portion of the Tom O'Brien Show is brought to you by Direction's Daily Leveraged and Inverse ETFs. Whether you're a bull or a bear, you choose the direction. Visit direction.com. Investing in the funds involves significant risk and should only be utilized by investors who understand the impact of leverage and actively monitor their portfolio. They are not designed to track the underlying index or security for more than a day. Before investing, carefully consider a fund's investment objective, risk, charges, and expenses contained in the prospectus available at direction.com. Read carefully. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 213. You get the NASDAQ up 233. S&Ps are up 56. Let's go to our man Tom in Tampa. Tom, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. How you doing?
Blue I'm doing great, man. How you been?
Over here.
I know. Good to hear from you.
Yeah, man. How you been?
I've been doing good, thank you. Yourself?
I'm doing great, man. That son of yours is a real trooper, man. He had that tumor removed, and he's back in the saddle within, what, 2-3 weeks?
Yeah, there's no doubt, man. That freaking golf ball,
great, man.
That's something else in your brain.
Yeah,
I'm telling you, man. Kind of weird.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I'm glad he's okay.
Me
yeah,
too, man. That's Big great. Time. Yeah. So what is the equity we're going to look at, Tom?
Symbols on it, Tom, are P like Paul, N like Nancy, C like Charlie, K like Kevin, F like Frank.
Okay. P, N, C, K, F, right?
Right.
Okay, I got it.
Galilean Gold Corporation.
I got it. It's Galilean Gold, right? Okay. So the low is... Let's see, 7 cents, the high is 20. This is an exploration company in North America. Okay, cool. So the exploration companies have no revenue, folks, okay? So let's take a look. Okay, so man, where'd you find this one, Tom? I get it, it's 14 cents, but there's like no trading on this thing. 1 second, hold on, let's see.
Yeah, there's not hardly any volume. It's on a Canadian, too.
Yeah,
it's on a Canadian.
You.
It's G. Go O dot V like Victor.
Yeah. Okay. You know,
but,
I don't know. I'd be careful, man. You know, they can get these pump and dumps going pretty good on Canada. So, I mean, it doesn't. Let me just look at
some. I mean, it really doesn't matter which one you buy it on, though, whether it be the Canada or the U.S. market.
Yeah,
right?
No. I understand that. I get that. Trust me. So, issue info. Let me see. Not underwritten. Okay, so this is, I'd be careful, man, you know, because what you have here, what they did here is that they took another company that was already public, you know, bottom line, that thing went south, then they took this company over. That's how they got the listing. But see, if you're watching Tiger TV right here, see all these numbers up here? When they saw not underwritten, that's when they turn around and they convert. You know, basically a company that's already out of business, they keep it alive because the listing itself is worth money, then they buy the listing. So you got to be careful, man.
Yeah, right.
Totally.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't know. I was just taking a little dab because it was a penny stock. I was just looking at it there.
Yeah,
so,
totally.
So.
Okay, man. Yeah. Well, listen, you have a great one, a safe one. Great hearing for you, Tom.
Okay, Tom,
next year for our lightning, though, Tom. Next year.
Yeah, man. Oh, yeah,
we'll see what happens with Stamkos, right? That's going to be a big deal, man. I mean, it's like, okay.
Oh, yeah. Right.
I know.
Yeah.
Okay, man. Yeah. Have a great one, a safe one.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
So when we take a look at this, I want to go back to, we're going to go back to this NVIDIA for a second because this is a big deal. Now, let's break this down. So the way it's going to work, NVDA, so watch this. This is like going to be wild. They're going to have to sell, and this is on, and I believe this is on for Friday. 1 second. Let me look at this calendar for a second. Calendar. 17th. Yeah, it's 21st. This is happening the 21st. Okay. So what's going to happen is that the XLK, now, the way this happens, folks, it happens on the exact day because what happens is that in order to stay to the regulations of the ETF, it's like you can't do it a couple days early or a day early because then your regulations inside the ETF structure, meaning that you're following a certain percentage that they have inside there. So the bottom line is going to be done the same day. So now watch. Now what can happen, which is they're saying in this article also. So it's State Street Global Advisors that run the XLK, okay? And they run all the S&P indices also. So the XLK is worth $71 billion. What you have right now is that Apple is at 21% of the weighting structure, as is Microsoft. And NVIDIA is at 4.5%. Well, both of those positions are going to change. What's going to happen is that the XLK, or State Street Advisors, is going to have to sell enough shares to bring Apple from 20% to 4.5%. Now watch this. So let's go like this. 1 second. I'm going to go to Apple first. Just so, well, here. No, hold it. Let me do it this way. 1 second. 4.5. Let me just see if it says. Okay, so here it is. So it's saying that State Street will purchase approximately $11 billion worth of NVIDIA and dump $12 billion of Apple. So, AAPL. What I'm doing right now, folks, I'm going to bring up Apple, and we're going to go look at State Street and see where they stand right now to see if just a ballpark of what we can do here. There's State Street right there. So right now, look at this. State Street has 558 million shares of Apple. Million. So if we do the math, okay. If you do the math on that, all we got to do, we can take... we'll take $11 billion, right, and divide it by 217, and that's going to tell us, how many shares they're going to sell, and then go to NVIDIA, NVDA. And then in NVIDIA, they own right now... Look at this. It says that they own 904 million. And they're going to have to buy. So we do the way we do that, we do 12 billion divided by 132. That'll give you how many shares they're going to buy. It's going to be upsetting to, well, I don't know if it's going to be upsetting to the market, but I can tell you this, knowing that if we go back to Apple for a second, now, Apple has this high volume high that wants to get tested from last Wednesday. I suspect that gets tested. The sale comes on. And we see where this flies, man. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We have the Dow up 225. NASDAQ's up 220. S&P's are up 54. We'll come right back.
If you're looking for potential trading setups in the stock market, then Rocket Equities and Options Report is a newsletter you should try. Tommy O'Brien delivers options and equity trades when the markets present them using a combination of fundamentals and technicals. Sign up for Rocket Equities and Options Report today with a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
For traders who crave risk, Direction's daily leveraged and inverse ETFs provide opportunities to magnify short-term perspectives with up to 3 times a daily leverage, utilize bull and bear funds from both sides of the trade, and trade through rapidly changing markets. These are highly leveraged ETFs with daily resetting designed for short-term trading, not long-term investing. Whether you're a bull or a bear, you choose the Direction. For up-to-date pricing and performance, go to Direction.com. Investing in the funds involves significant risk and should only be utilized by investors who understand the impact of leverage and actively monitor their portfolio. They are not designed to track the underlying index or security for more than a day. Before investing, carefully consider a fund's investment objective, risk, charges, and expenses contained in the prospectus available at direction.com. Read carefully. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter, a must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN has launched the Tiger's Den, hosted at Discord. TFNN has been educating traders for more than 20 years with live programming hosted by a variety of professional traders during market hours. The Tiger's Den, available to all tigers and tigresses for just $1 for the year. There's no catch or added costs when you join our community of traders. Sign up today and become a part of this educational community of traders. Just visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This program is brought to you by Vista Gold, traded on the NYSE American and TSX under the symbol VGZ.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow index is up 248. You get the NASDAQ up 220. S&Ps are up 56. Let's go to the beautiful cliffs of Gloucester. Looking out, see our man Frank. Frank, what's going on, brother? How you doing?
Hey. Tommy, pretty good. Happy Father's Day, belated.
Happy Father's Day. So good to hear from you, man. How's everyone doing?
Oh, everybody's fine, thank you. You and you on your side?
Everyone's doing good. We were down the Vinoy for the weekend having a good time with Tommy and little Tommy, and we had a blast. So yeah, it was fun seeing everyone and hanging out with everyone. You know how that goes. It's nice.
Oh, yeah. I had my grandkids on the beach yesterday afternoon.
Exactly. Yeah.
We were in sweatshirts, but we were on the beach.
So, you're not going to be wearing sweatshirts tomorrow, I heard. I was talking to Caitlin, and she's telling me you got a heat one coming in, right?
Yeah, I put a couple of air conditioners in the windows today.
She did the same thing. I love it. I was talking to, and it, you know, for across the country, folks, what happens, you know, up in New England still, I mean, in Boston, we're still into air conditioners in the windows up there, so.
Oh, yeah. No, I mean, it was 79 here today, and where my son lives in Reading, about 30 miles inland, it was 89.
Okay, so, yeah, I know. Tomorrow they're saying 95, man, up in Boston. So that's pretty intense, man. No doubt.
Yeah, we may get well into the 80s.
Yeah, you're not right where you are is just gorgeous, man.
I'd love. Perfect.
I know you know this. I've told you before. It would happen, folks, is that when I was really young, when I was sailing a lot, would sail up there, and oh my God, when you look at these cliffs, you just can't believe how gorgeous it is. Because it's also the first time that you see water. I mean, you see land for a while. We'd go from there up to Marblehead, and it was always nice. Seeing those cliffs, like, was like, okay, man, thank God I'm not lost.
you feel like Christopher Columbus. Huh?
No, Dad, let me tell you, the first couple of times that you're sailing, or just any, you know, you don't have to be sailing, you can be motorboating too, and you don't see land, then you see land. It's always a big thing. It's still a big thing when I sail now and see land.
You know,
and this is even with the, you know your coordinates are right, you know everything's right, but let me tell you, folks, it's great seeing land. It's like, okay, man, we got the right thing happening here, so. So we're going to look at an eco eagle, right, Frank?
Yeah, an eco eagle. And, you know, I've made so much money in your gold report. I must have paid for the thing, the annual subscription, about 10 times in the last few months. So
I appreciate it.
It's been great, but have a couple still left over of precious metal stocks, and this is one of them. And it looks like it's holding pretty strong to me.
It is. There's no doubt. But, you know, I'm nervous, man. And, you know, it's good to be nervous, folks, okay? That's the fact. But just bottom line, like today, Frank, like you see, you know, yeah, we're popping 22 cents, but you see 1.3 million, it's like that doesn't work.
But it's got that nice little sideways trend, and it's on low volume.
It does.
It looks like it has support.
I agree. There's no doubt. I mean, look at that support right there. That's the bar. The bar, well, you get a couple of them. You get 417, and then we also have right there. And they're at the same, almost at the same place. That being said, you know, you can put the stop in. I mean, I'm sure you have a stop. Where I'm coming from with all of this, folks, is that it has to do with this dollar. And what happens, you know, in markets in general, you can go down very fast. In the gold market, folks, it accelerates, you know, compared to the S&P. So that's what you're hearing off me, Frank, in the gold report more than anything. Do you know what I'm saying? So,
I hear you.
Yeah.
Where would you put the stop on this?
On AEM, what I do here, so if we take a look, the next time, so this is good. So they don't come out with numbers to 731. They're going to expect 1.9 billion and 79 cents to the bottom line, which is a good number, okay? So you got, what is that? That's too far. 6080 is too far. And then the high volume low is 6309. No, 63 flat. I'd put it under the 63 flat. You're dealing with here. Go like this.
Okay.
You're dealing with that high volume. That should hold it. But the problem is that high volume low is like $60, and I wouldn't take four more dollars. It's not worth it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like 60. You know, you could do 62, like 60 or something like that. It's not that bad.
Okay.
You got, you know, because the bottom of the bar from last week is 63.80, and that's going to get tested, man. That's a high volume low. The problem is, and it just blows that away, and they decide to take these things south. See, because I think my take is I think they're going to take them down to the breakout area. And if we look at the GDX, I don't mean to swap with you here,
really?
But I can get a better feel on the GDX. And see, the GDX, you're at 33, man. I think this thing's going to, you know, kind of get down to this 31, man. I think it's going to croak. I think what we're doing right now is actually building cars that are trying to break this area. But it all has to do with the dollar, you know. Yeah. So it's like, and I think what we're going to have, Frank, is this. But, you know, the broad market's been, staying up beyond belief, right? There's no doubt about that.
Oh, it's ridiculous.
But that being said, you know, as Steve was talking about, you're all a TD, nine counts at the highs.
Yeah.
The dollar is at a high. It's like, okay, man. Now, what does happen, folks, now this is what's kind of cool, actually. At the end of an extraordinary run, this is what normally happens, just what we have happened today. Now, the question is, though, it can happen a couple days in a row, and they get everyone out. You know what I'm saying? Meaning anyone that's shot.
What happened?
They just keep going up. You know what I'm saying?
This is a melt-up today.
You get a melt-up tomorrow. Because I think what you're going to have is that when the broad market pulls back, the gold market's going to go too. You know? And what you had there, we were in the money in a monster way, folks. So we took it all. I took it all on Friday, basically.
Oh, it was delicious.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, that was the risk is, okay, you know, that we took our money on one side. Then the other side of that, though, is, you know, if we do get a pullback, we're going to be in at prices that we're going to love. So it was one of those deals.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, It's hard to tell. I don't get this nervous that often. Sometimes when I get nervous, yeah, the freaking market will go up another 1,000 points, and sometimes I get it right. You know what I mean? So
I just figured that
this was, you know, as they say, if you're taking a profit, you're going to win. So, and I didn't want to give it back.
Yep.
But an Eco Eagle's a great stock. I mean, there's no doubt about it. But it's a tough one, man. You see, the problem, and this is why I did it too. The problem with the gold market, which stops folks, is this. Is that if gold's down pre-market, the dollar's up, everything gaps down. And that's why I didn't want them gap over our stops. You know what I'm saying?
So yeah.
I wish I could give you some better feedback, Frank.
That's all right. We're gonna take them all again. The next leg up is coming.
No, it is. I'm bold. There's no doubt, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
The stock market is a delicate interconnecting web of commodities, equities, and trader psychology. When one string of the web is pulled, it has a ripple effect across the broader market. This is where opportunity lies. But how are you to gather all of this information into one cohesive model when you're already spending your energy looking for any possible trade opportunities? Luckily, you don't have to worry about that, as Tom O'Brien has brought all important market news to you in one single newsletter, Market Insights. Market Insights provides a daily overview of what's happening in the indexes, bonds, gold, and more. Follow along with Tom daily as he analyzes the components that affect the overall movement of the stock market, giving insight into how each one plays either a bullish or bearish role. Tom also analyzes specific equities that he believes has the potential to make huge returns, and his track record proves his analysis right. All first-time subscribers receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Don't let the market leave you in the dust.
In the world of trading, only a few names stand out like Larry Pesavento. A pro's pro with over 50 years of experience, Larry has seen it all. A former Chicago Mercantile Exchange member, Larry has authored 10 books and trained over 1,000 traders with his unmatched expertise. Introducing Fibonacci 24/7, Larry Pesavento's daily trading service that turns the complexity of markets into opportunities. Published every Sunday, receive a comprehensive report packed with detailed commentary, charts, and videos that illuminate the patterns shaping the markets, with updates throughout the week exclusively for subscribers. Whether through charts or videos, Larry's analysis is your roadmap to navigating the markets. You can sign up now at TFNN.com for just $97. And with all TFNN newsletters backed by a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. For all the details, visit TFNN.com. You'll find Fibonacci 24/7 right under the newsletters tab.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter. A must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials up 193. You get the NASDAQ up 77. S&Ps are up 45. Let's go to the E-minis. So, bottom line, you know, they just sold that E-mini down 10 quick ones. And let's see what we got here. Okay, so, yeah, 10 quick ones are nothing in this market, man. Now, look at this. On both of these sells, these are sells for sure. The last 10 minutes, you get 12,000 contracts and 12,000. We hit the highs with 13,000. Yeah, we hit that 14 and 13. We just did, let's see, what do we got here? Oh, this is a monster one. Oh, this is going to be a big bomb, man. This is only 5 minutes into the bar, and we've done 13,000. So they are selling it down. So that would be 5472 right there. That's one. If it breaks that, it really gets some action. If it breaks that, we're talking, 5464. Well, it's not that. That's 14 points down. You end up with that, if that's what we get. Now, that could get interesting. Yeah, no, I get the deal about where the volume is, right? Meaning that we're rolling, folks, okay? Realistically, what happens, though, people roll early. This is still the contract. The M is still the contract. It should be anyway. What do we got? 1.4 million contracts? Yeah. Because the MSU for... Yeah, no. Yeah, they're rolling. Yeah, there's 1.9. It's better. Yeah. Man, that was a quick hour. Quick, quick, quick. Always remember, folks, the bank can claw your heart out. The bull can run you over. And thank God, there's always another trade. Health, happiness, and prosperity. Have a great night, folks. Have a safe night. And come join Tommy, Jacob tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. Great show, folks. Bam! Go get him, folks.